Welcome students to our new video. Today we are going to study about a very important topic from the immune organs, which is bursa of fabricus. Let's see what is bursa of fabricus. So first we are going to see about the discovery of bursa of fabricus. In 1960, Bruce Glick showed that the removal of bursa is in a newly hatched chicks severely impaired the ability of the adult birds to produce antibody. So first of all, I want to explain what is bursa. So students, we all have the immune organs like B cell is the lymphocyte, and it is mainly produced by the in the bone marrow. So imagine that this bursa of fabricus is same as a bone marrow. So first, there are no permission to study on humans. So this scientist in 1960, Bruce Glick, studied on the chicks, and these chicks he removes the bursa. It is an organ which produces the B cells in the chickens. So when the Bruce Glick removed that bursa, the newly hatched chick is severely impaired the ability to produce the antibodies. And in the second experiment, it gave the conflicting result that in the first peasant, bursa cell produced antibody to bovine immunoglobulin, and whereas in the second, the bursa fabricus was unable to produce the plaque forming cell to sheep red RBC. These both are the test, the sheep red RBC test, and the first is the immunoglobulin, bovine immunoglobulin. These are the two tests to check the formation of antibody. So the scientists remove that organ and check for these two tests. Let's see the next. So why the bursa of fabricus is so important in the chickens? So the bursa of fabricus function as a central lymphoid organ, and it require for the development of the antigen specific B cells. And this bursa of fabricus is necessary for the development of post-bursal B cell population, including the mature antigen B cell and the self-renewing post-bursal stem cell. So we all know that all lymphoid organ are formed from the hematopoietic stem cell, and this in humans it is formed from the hematopoietic stem cell, from which the lymphoid progenitor is formed, and from the lymphoid progenitor cell, B and T cell are formed. And then the name itself indicate that B cell are produced in bone marrow and mature in bone marrow, and T cell are in thymus. So on the basis of their lymphoid organ maturation, the name is given. And we all know that the function of B cell and T cell. So let's see the structure of bursa of fabricus. So how the structure of bursa of fabricus look like? It look like a sac. It look like a sac like structure. And on zooming, student, you can see that this bursa of fabricus contain the two layer. The first outer layer is cortex, and the inner layer is medulla. So what happened in this bursa? That this bursa of fabricus contain a number of lymphoid lobules and a crypt-like folds. Crypt-like fold means that these organs. Crypt-like fold means crypt. This is called as the crypt, and this organ contain many fold, crypt-like folds. This is cortex, and this is the inner part is medulla. So how the production of these B cells are takes place in the bursa? The inner part of the bursa, where medulla, where the formation of B cells are takes place, and this after the formation of the B cells, the B cell maturation also takes place in the bursa. And various lobules are present, and the macrophages are present, and a reticular epithelial cell is present, interfollicular tissues are present. But students, you are thinking, why macrophages are present? Why? And the answer for this why is that the macrophage's main function is phagocytosis, and the any dead cell, dead material or dead B cell which is not proper in function, after production of B cell, every cell is not functioning because the after production of B cell, the proliferation of B cell is there. And here the if the B cell is not functioning properly, it has been degraded and it has been phagocytized by these macrophages and transferred to the vacuoles. So it is another topic. So our main focus is on the bursa of fabricus. So the lumen opens into the proctoderm, which is the inner part of the bursa, and like the thymus, the lobule have a cortex medulla and the lymphocyte supported by the epithelial cell. So this whole structure is supported by the cortex and the epithelial cells. And to remember the bursa of fabricus, it is very easy that it look like a sack like a structure. It has a sack like structure, like we use the sack for market use or any other carrying purposes. It is a sack like structure. So student, all clear with this? So we are going to see the component of bursa, or from which cells the bursa of fabricus is made. The bursa of fabricus is mainly made up of the epithelial cell, and it consists of lymphocyte embedded in the fold of epithelial cell. As I earlier explained in the structure, it has a crypt or fold like structure is there, and this fold made up of the epithelial cells and lymphocyte embedded are there, and this scattered throughout the folds are lymphoid follicles. All the in the circular structure you are seeing in the bursa of fabricus are the lymphoid follicles, where lymphoid progenitor cells are there, and a lymphoid progenitor cell produce the B cells and T cell, and after production of these cells, they have been maturation is there, and the whole maturation of the B cell in chickens, not in humans, in chickens, done in the bursa of fabricus. So the other cells like follicle associated epithelial cell is there, interfollicular associated epithelium cell is there, and this the main structure, the main function of follicle cell are these are the small secretory cells, and these play a very important role like a cavity or a sac or a cavity or a gland. So why these three terms I use? Because any cavity, sac or a gland, the main function of these three terms is to store, and these cavity like things store the B cell or a sac store the B cell. And why the storage of B cell is there? For the maturation of the B cell. And without maturation, the B cell are not go for the further process for the antibody production, or B cell cloning is there, or antibody cloning. So without maturation, the B cell are not permitted out in the bloodstream. So follicles are very important. Next is the what happened if we the bursa of fabricus is affected. But before going to this, I am going to explain why we are studying bursa. Because bursa of fabricus structure and function are very very similar to bone marrow in humans. It is somehow it is structurally somehow different, but functionally same to same. The bursa of fabricus is same to same in chickens, and our bone marrow is same in human. If we better understand the bursa of fabricus, it is very easy to understand the bone marrow function and B cell proliferation and production. So let's see what happen if the bursa of fabricus is get affected. If bursa of fabricus is affected, it hamper the production of the B cell and maturation of B cell. So infectious bursal diseases are there, which are viral diseases in poultry, and typically these viruses attack the bursa of young birds and preventing the development of the immune system. So we all know that the viruses, any virus, it mainly affect the immune system, because if the immune system of any animal is hampered, the whole body get very easy to adapt by the parasite or host. So these viruses attack the young birds because the immune system of young birds are very low, and it affects the young birds like which are the chicks of 10 to 12 days, and after affecting it attack on the bursa, and then the bursa get affected, then no B cell are there, and it is a very easy host for that virus. So and these act like a immunosuppressive. That we all know that whole immune suppression is there, no B cell production, no antibody production, and it is a very good home for that virus. Understand, student? So these avian immunosuppressive disease refer to those avian diseases caused by pathogen that target and damage the immune organs or cells of the bird, and after infection these cells die. So every virus has a strategy to attack the host, and in avians, in birds, it attacked on the bursa fabricus, and even in the use we study in the AIDS that the retrovirus or HIV virus affect the T helper cell of humans, and if T helper cell is hampered, you all know what happened to the human body, and our whole body become a good platform for that virus to attack. And in AIDS we get a whole syndrome of disease, whole bunch of disease. So that is a different topic, but in bursa fabricus we have to remember the discovery that it is discovered by the Bruce Gilk, by the two experiment, by the removal of bursa. And second is the importance, why bursa is very important, because it is a major production house of B cell, and where B cells are mature and proliferation is there, and antigen specific B cell. Remember, student, I also forgot, but you have to remember that maturation of antigen specific B cells are there. And we have to also remember the structure, that it is a sac-like structure, remember, student, and the components, epithelial tissues, and the disease, what happened to it, then what will be the consequence. So that's all with my lecture. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe.